I mean, really took a day off, like unplugged your phone, ignored your email, relaxed, regrouped. Well, for Robert Morris, it had been 5 long years, and then he had a meltdown.
Robert Morris is the founding senior pastor of Gateway Church that has over 39,000 members, working for 5 years without rest, eventually caught up with him.
Open my sock drawer, no socks. And I sat down in my closet with just my underwear on and cried. And I went to lunch with Pastor Tom Lane that day, and I leaned across the table to him and I said, "Pastor Tom, I'm losing my mind." He said, "You're not losing your mind, you're exhausted."
In his book, Take the Day Off, Pastor Morris shares why rest is central to your well-being and how by honoring the Sabbath day, you can be more effective and creative.
Please welcome back to the 700 Club, Robert Morris, talking about his new book, Take the Day Off. Tell us a little bit about what happened that day after 5 years, because people, whether they admit it or not, we can relate.
Yeah, well, right before the socks, when there were no socks, I opened my underwear drawer and there was only one pair left. But I remember standing there thinking, what am I going to do tomorrow? You know, pastors should wear underwear. They shouldn't talk about it on TV, but they ought to wear it, you know? So I just thought, what am I going to do? But I couldn't think.
That's the whole.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So it's not just that we get tired physically. We get tired spiritually, obviously, and we're weak to the enemy and temptation, but we get tired mentally and emotionally. And when I taught this, I remember a doctor in our church thought, you know what? I haven't been taking a day off, really. And so on Sundays, he said, I'm going to take the day off, not think about my practice. And it, all of a sudden, he got this idea when he was lying down to go to sleep that night. And he thought, I got to write this down. And he thought, well, wait, it's the Sabbath. But he looked, and it was 12:01 a.m. Monday. But here's the great thing. He writes it down. It is now revolutionizing the industry, this one idea that he got, because his mind was relaxed, and he could think and create again.
You had quite a health crisis. I mean, almost died. Did that play into this as well, into understanding, man, I need to just slow down a little bit?
Yeah, well, I was trying to slow down, and you just kind of, you get convicted, and you do it, and then you kind of let go, and then you do it.
The world enters.
Yeah, and so we were at our place out in the country slowing down, but I passed out. And I told Debbie, I feel like I'm losing blood. And because I'd had a ulcer before, but I wasn't passing blood. But they came and they couldn't get my blood pressure. It was too low to read even.
Wow.
They called the helicopter. I got to the hospital. I'd lost over 50% of my blood. And I had 2 torn veins that were bleeding internally.
Wow.
And so you can see how bad I looked. And so they had to do 2 emergency surgeries. But that really did reinforce you've got to slow down and rest, because it had slowly creeped back into my life working 7 days a week.
Why do we struggle so much with that? I mean, you know, God obviously knew we needed it. It's one of the big 10, take a Sabbath rest. It's for us, not for him or the Sabbath. So why do we struggle with that?
I think we struggle with it because really of the fall of sin, our sin nature, because we're performance oriented.
Yeah.
And we know we don't have to perform for our salvation. We've got that it's by grace. But I might have to perform for you. I might have to try to come and do a good job. So I better think about it and get prepared, or for the message, or for, you know, something I'm doing for work, a presentation. Instead of, if I take that day off, I'll be rested and refreshed and actually do a better job at work. It's a matter of trusting God that He can do a better job in 6 days than I can in 7.
And sometimes I think, Robert, we demand it of ourselves, not even for anybody else. We perform for us instead of the audience of one we're supposed to perform for.
Yep. There's something in us that we try to, even from our childhood, we try to overcome and show people, no, we are hard workers.
So what are the signs of burnout? I mean, you mentioned some of the things you experienced, you know, just this sense of, I can't do this anymore, not being able to think in process as you normally could. What else should
Well, one of the things I didn't mention, we have 4 tanks that need to be refilled and refreshed every day. And that's a spiritual tank, a physical tank, a mental tank, and an emotional tank. And so I talked a little about physical and mental and spiritual, but the emotional. What about you don't have enough emotions for your kids? You don't have emotions for your spouse. You're getting cranky, irritable. Debbie will say to me, you need to take a day off. And she's right.
So how do we begin that process? It will seem very foreign to others. I mentioned to you before we came out of that commercial, I did a study on the Sabbath in the Old Testament a few years ago, and God's serious about that. I mean, serious repercussions if we don't take a Sabbath rest. But how do we begin?
Yeah, well, it's actually easy. You schedule it.
Yeah.
If you think about it, if you're going to have lunch with someone, you schedule it so you don't miss it. If you're going to, go somewhere and speak, you schedule it. Whatever it is, we put it on our schedule. So I called a pastor years ago. This is when God was trying to teach me this. We were trying to have lunch. And so I was saying, what about Monday? No, I'm out of town. What about Tuesday? I have meetings. I said, well, what do you have scheduled Thursday? And he said, nothing. I said, well, great, let's go to lunch. He said, no, he said, I can't go to lunch Thursday. I said, I thought you said you have nothing scheduled. He said, that's right. He said, I have nothing scheduled for Thursday. I'm going to do nothing on Thursday. And he said, I'd like to talk to you about it when we get together. And he told me how he was sick in the hospital. They didn't know what was wrong. And God spoke to him about this. And he repented and was healed, and he from that time on, he takes a day off.
Can I ask you how you structured that? Because when people are used to the frenetic pace that we all keep, and then you take a day off, what do you do on your day off?
You know, I get asked that all the time. I teach pastors this, I teach business leaders, and they always ask me, what do you do on your day off? And I say, actually, that's the wrong question. It's not what do you do, it's what do you not do.
Yeah.
So I don't do anything related to work. What all of us have a calling on our lives. And whatever that calling is, that helps other people.
Yeah.
And so if we'll just, on that day, if I answer emails for work, I don't do it one day a week. Phone calls for work, I don't do it one day a week. Studying for messages, writing books, whatever that is, I stop that one day a week, so that I'm refreshed to do that calling God has on my life.
Amen. Listen, Robert's book is called Take the Day Off, and it's available wherever books are sold. We all need it. It's the pretty blue book with the hammock on the cover. Doesn't that look inviting? Get a hold of it, because that day off is God's plan for your health and well-being. Thank you. What a wonderful